us, greater is the God who's in us. God proves his love for us. While we were yet sinners, we were yet sinners. Christ died upon the cross to bring us forgiveness. God proves his love for us. While we were yet sinners, we were yet sinners. Christ died upon the cross.
and peace have found me. I remember what you said, you will never ever leave me. So I'm holding on to all your promises. I build my life on you, on the strength of your love and your mercy and truth. On this rock I stand, not on shifting sand. I build my life on you, Jesus, Jesus.
When the wind and rain try to wash away my shelter,
that we can earn it. There's no way that we deserve it. His love is free, so free. How can it be? How can it be? Even when our hearts condemn us, greater is the God who's in us. God proves his
and peace have found me. I remember what you said, you will never ever leave.
As a father, Hello. Hi, friend. How are you doing? You're doing very well, thank you. I hope you're so excited for today. By the way, have you seen Uncle Chachu? He promised us an exciting story today. And we are all looking forward to learning so much. I better go find him. Wait there for me. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back, okay? Uncle Chachu! Uncle Chachu! Uncle Chachu! Uncle Chachu! Hello! Hi everyone! Don't mind me. I'll be on the couch very soon. I'm just having a little fun here with my friends. Stop it! They are all looking forward so much to today's story. And I hope you are too. We're going to have so much fun and learn a lot. So sit back, relax, and I'll be with you in just a moment. See you soon!
So for the past two Sundays, we have been learning about right and wrong. We have been looking at the commandments that God gave to the people of Israel. Now, these commandments were given a long time ago, but they are still very important for us today because they teach us what is right and wrong. So we have looked at two of these commandments so far. But before we remind ourselves of these two, a quick quiz. How many commandments did God give to the people of Israel? I'm sure we all know the answer. This is a very easy one. So let's say it together. 10 commandments. Good. So what about the two that we learned? Do we remember them? What's the first one? Okay, so the first one is, you shall have no other gods before me, right? Okay, and the second one, what is the second one? Good. The second one is, you shall not make for yourself a carved image. Very good. So today we are going to learn two new commandments. But before we start our lesson, let's sit down quietly, settle down, and watch this.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm so glad you stayed. I knew you would. Now, we're going to go into our lesson for today. Going to be learning something exciting about our tongues, how sometimes we use them in ways that are not good, and how we can use them in ways that are very good. Now, who knows what we use our tongues for? Yeah, we use it to taste food, right? That's good. Another important thing we use our tongue for is to talk and to demonstrate that. Everyone, I want you to say this sentence with me. Mommy said she is going to the store. Say it after me. Mommy said she's going to the store. Good. Now, I want everyone to stick their tongues out like this. Right? Everyone point at your tongue. Good. So now, we're going to try and say the same sentence, but this time with our tongues out. Let's try it again.
Mommy said she's going to the store.
Did you hear me? I was saying, Mommy said she's going to the store. I'm going to try again.
Mommy said she's going to the store.
You saw how that turned out, right? That's because our tongues help us say words. Today, we're going to learn about how we are supposed to use those words, which our tongues help us to say. But before we do that, we're going to have a short show presented to you by Mickey and the Gang. They are going to be putting on a wonderful play for us. So I want you to sit down and stay tuned. Let's enjoy it.
Miss Leona, Messi on the ball.
dribbles one player, dribbles the second one, and he shoots, and it's a goal! Lionel Messi gets this hat trick! Lionel Messi, what a goal! Okay, and there's another chance for Messi. Messi is through on goal, and he shoots! No! What did I do? No! Daddy's favorite picture! I'm in so much trouble! What's happening here? Mickey Jr.? Mickey Jr.? Where are you?
Hello, Daddy.
Where's your brother?
I think he's in the bedroom.
You know what happened here? Who broke their picture?
Oh, Daddy, was it me?
Get me your brother.
Okay.
Children are in so much trouble.
Yes, Daddy.
Who broke their picture? So angry. If I tell the truth, I don't think you'll forgive me. This time, I have to lie.
Daddy, it was Mickey Jr. the second.
What? I asked him about it. He said he didn't know.
But Daddy, I heard him in the room. He was playing and then I heard a loud scratch. Like something breaking. Yes.
Call me your brother. I heard it was you who broke the car.
No, that is not true.
Your brother tells me it was me. He heard you playing here and you broke it. No, Daddy, I'm very disappointed in you. I'll think about what punishment to give you for this. Go to your room for now and don't come out till later.
Was it me?
I was very lucky. If I didn't lie, I would have been in so much trouble. Looks like that was my only choice. You guys think I did the right thing? Okay, welcome back once again. I hope we all saw what happened in our little show. We saw what Mickey Jr. the first did to baby Mickey Jr. the second. Was that very nice? I definitely don't think so. Going to be taking a look at what the Bible says about how we are to use our tongues. In the book of Exodus, let me just get my Bible. Please hold on. Great, here we go. In the book of Exodus, chapter 20, God gave the Israelites the 10 commandments. And today we are going to be focusing on two of them. The first commandment, which is the third one. It's which one? The third commandment. And I'm going to read it to you from Exodus 20, verse 7. Exodus 20, verse 7 tells us that you shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. What does this mean? This means that we are not to mention God or Jesus' name anyhow or anytime we want, especially when we are not actually talking about him. So we are only supposed to mention God and Jesus' name in a very respectful manner and when we are actually saying something about them. Let's look at an example of this.
Jesus, this weather is terrible.
Good. So what did we see in the example? Was the person actually talking about Jesus or the weather? Yes, they were talking about the weather, but they still mentioned Jesus' name, which is what we are not supposed to do. Now, let's look at the next commandment, which is the... How many fingers am I holding up? Nine. The ninth commandment. Great. And this one is found in Exodus 20, verse 16. And it tells us, you shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not do what? Shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. What does this mean? This simply means that we are not supposed to lie. We saw what Mickey Jr. did in the now play, right? Blamed everything on his little brother, even though it was he who did it. That is exactly what this verse is telling us. We are not supposed to bear false witness against our brothers. We are not supposed to lie. So these are some of the ways in which we do things that do not please God. Can we think of other examples where we say things that don't please God? Okay, I have another example. If you are in school and one of your friends brings a very nice pencil to class, it is so unique and it looks so pretty, and you ask your friend that, "I want to hold this pencil," your friend tells you, "No, I'll let you hold it," and later you see the pencil lying on the table, you decide that you teach this friend a lesson, so you take the pencil and you hide it. And then your friend comes later crying and is looking for his pencil. "Where's my pencil? Where's my pencil?" The teacher goes around and asking everyone, "Have you seen the pencil? Have you seen the pencil?" And the teacher asks you, "Have you seen the pencil?" And you tell the teacher, "No, me, I haven't touched the pencil. I haven't seen it. When I asked him to show it to me earlier today, he said he would let me hold it. And me, I left it for him." That's another way in which we lie and say things that do not please God, which is not good. Now, why did God give these commandments? These things God told them not to do, He gave them because they are sinful. So that is why God told them not to do. So telling lies is sin, and using God's name in vain, misusing His name, is also sin. What does sin mean? Sin is anything that we think, do, or say that is not pleasing to God. So in this case, lying is sin as well. And why doesn't God like it when we sin? Because God is holy. God is holy. What that means is that He has no sin in Him. He has never sinned and He will never sin. And therefore God cannot stand sin. Can't stand it when we do bad things. So God is holy. He does not like sin, which is why lying and saying or using God's name in vain are sinful. Great. Now, we're going to go on to another part of the Bible which will teach us about why it is important for us to control our tongues or control the words we say. It's going to show us a number of images of very small, tiny things that control very big things. So let's all listen closely. You're going to tell me what the small things are and what the big thing is that it controls. If you don't know what they are, I'll help us point them out. So let's go through. I'm reading from James chapter 3, from verse 3. And it tells us that, "Now, when we put bits into the mouths of horses to make them obey us, we also guide the whole animal. And consider ships, though very large and driven by fierce winds, they are guided by a very small rudder wherever the will of the pilot directs." Amen. Now, from our passage, what were the two images the scripture gave us? The first one was a what? The horse. That's right. And then a bit. If you don't know what a bit is, the bit is the small thing they put in the horse's mouth. They connect the rope to it, so it helps them to direct the horse where the rider wants it to go. Good. And the second one was what? I'll give you a hint. It's on the sea. A ship, yes, or a boat. And the ship is controlled by something called a rudder. The rudder is that small wheel that you see the pilot turning, which controls the entire ship. So you can see a very large ship, but the pilot using just a small rudder to control it. So those were the two images we saw. Now, let's go on to see how the tongue is sometimes like these things. So I continue. "So too, the tongue is a small part of the body, but it does great things. Consider how a large forest is set on fire by a very small spark. The tongue be like a spark that sets the forest on fire." So we see that the tongue can also be used to do
great things, though it is very small. The great things that the tongue does may sometimes be good or bad, in the same way that the spark, a small spark, may set the whole forest on fire. The tongue too may cause big problems in the things we say. When we say things that are not nice, we can cause people to become angry. We can cause people to become very sad as well. So though very small, the tongue can make us say words that will be very hurtful and cause people to cry. But the tongue can also be used for good, which is how God wants us to use it. So we are going to go through a few examples of how we can use the tongue for good. We do not want our tongues to be like the spark that sets a whole forest on fire and causes big problems. But we can use our tongue for good. When we are God's friends, He's able to help us to say things and say words that are helpful. So let's look at some examples of those. Now, let's look at the following scenarios and see how we can say helpful things that will be pleasing to God and not be like the tongue that is setting a whole forest on fire or causing big problems. If we have a new colleague or a new classmate who came to school for the first time and has no friends, we could say nice things by befriending them and saying, "Welcome to the class. I'm so glad you are here, and I'll be happy to help you if you need any help." That's one way we can say a helpful thing. Another way is if one of your friends didn't do very well in an exam and is feeling very sad. Instead of going to mock them and say, "Ha ha ha ha, you were last, you didn't do well in the exam," we could rather go and be very helpful and polite and say that, "I'm very sorry you did poorly in the exam. I hope you do better next time. I'll even be willing to help you study if you need help." That will be pleasing to God. Another way is if someone lost their money and is searching desperately for it, you don't go and tease the person and say, "You are so careless, you lost your money, next time be more careful." But rather, you can go and say, "Oh, I'm sorry you lost your money. I'll be very happy to help you look for it." That is helpful. Another way is if you're on a team with some friends, maybe you're all playing football and you're not doing very well that game, and your teammate comes at you very angry and say, "You are so bad at this game. I hope I'm never on the same team with you again." That's not very nice. But that doesn't mean we are also supposed to respond in a way that is also not nice. But we should rather keep our calm and say, "Sorry, I'm not doing well." Or we could just decide to keep quiet and not say anything that will not be helpful. I'm sure you can see from this that it's not always easy to say things that are helpful. But don't worry, God is always willing to help us once we become His friends. If you've ever prayed and asked Jesus Christ to become your friend or accepted Him into your heart, He has sent His Holy Spirit to come and help you. And He is able to help you to say good things or use our tongues in ways that are pleasing to Him. And don't worry, if you have never done this before, you've never asked Jesus to come into your life and be your special friend so that He can help you to say things that are helpful, you are going to get the opportunity to do that today. So don't worry at all. The last thing I want us to see is that, how many of us know an orange tree? We've seen orange before. Or any tree, you can mention any tree you know, of any fruit or any vegetable, tomato plants, it can be an orange tree, a mango tree, pawpaw tree, any of them. How many of you have ever seen an orange tree that the first time it fruits, there are oranges on it, but the next time we see pawpaw on it? Have any of you seen that before? Me either. The same way, God wants our tongues to be like a tree. We should not use our tongues sometimes to say good things and at other times use our tongues to say terrible things that are hurtful to people. God doesn't want that at all. Our tongue should always be used for good things. It should always bring forth good fruit, just like the orange tree always brings forth orange, or the pawpaw tree always brings forth pawpaw. our tongue should always bring forth good things. And like I said, God is willing to help us to do just that. Awesome! You guys have been such a good audience, and I know you've learned a lot. So, I said there'll be the opportunity for those who want Jesus to be their friend as well, so that he can help them see good things and not sin against him. We are going to do that now. If you'd like to do that, I want you to close your eyes with me and say this prayer after me. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you, Lord, for teaching me today that you are a holy God and that you don't like sin. Father, I don't want to sin anymore as well. So I pray that you send your Son, Jesus Christ, to come and live in me and to be with me and help me not to sin anymore. Thank you, Jesus, for coming into my life. Amen. Great! If you just said this prayer, Jesus is now your friend and he is going to help you to say things that glorify God. Woo! Aren't you excited, guys? Good. Good. Now, we are going to see another show from Mickey and the Gang. They are going to show us what Mickey Jr. should have done instead of lying when Mickey Sr. asked him who broke the picture. Let's have a look.
What happened here? Mickey Jr.! Mickey Jr.!
Yes, Daddy?
Oh, I was actually looking for your brother. Where is he?
I don't think he's in the bedroom.
Do you know what happened here? Who broke this glass?
Daddy, I don't know, but was it me?
Get me your brother.
Okay. Mickey Jr.! Big bro! Daddy's calling you.
Yes, Daddy. Do you know what happened here?
But I remember from Sunday school last week, we thought that God doesn't like lying. Doesn't please him. Because God doesn't like sin, and lying is sin, I think I'll tell the truth, no matter what will happen. I know that will make God happy. Daddy, I was playing football, even though I know you told us not to do so inside the house. And I kicked the ball and it hit the picture and it broke. I'm very sorry, Daddy. I'll not do that again.
I'm glad that you told the truth. If you had been lying and I'd found out later on, I'd have been very angry. But since you told the truth, I only let you off with a warning. Next time, don't do that again.
Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Daddy. Oh, thank you, Daddy.
Then you can go now.
Wow, I'm so proud of you, Mickey Jr. You did the right thing. You told the truth. And you saw that Daddy was appreciative of that. He was happy when you told him the truth. Instead of lying, and later you would have found out if you're angry. I've learned so much. Wow. Thank you, Mickey Jr. I hope you all saw what Mickey did. Let's try and follow his example. Great. You guys have been a great audience today, and I'm so glad to have been able to come with you and share this lesson from the Bible. We are now going to have a nice song to remind us of our lesson for today. So I want you all to stay still and listen to the lesson, to the song.
Now you may be able to tame a bucking bronco or a wildcat, but you can't tame a tongue. If your tongue is always getting you into trouble, saying things that shouldn't be said, here's something you can do.
Welcome back, guys. I hope you enjoyed the song. I did. I really enjoyed it. It reminded me that I must use my tongue to make that pleases God. Great. So we are going to have our memory verse today, and I would hand over to Auntie Maria, who will take us through the memory verse. Let's listen closely to her and make sure that we are able to memorize it. I'll see you guys back here.
So I hope that we paid attention to the lesson that we have learned our two new commandments. To help us to remember these commandments, we are going to learn Bible verses. Yes, Bible verses. Today we have two memory verses. Our first Bible verse is from Exodus chapter 20, verse 7. Exodus chapter 20, verse 7. And it says, "You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain." Let's break it down into three parts so it's easy for us to learn. So our first part, you shall not. Let's say it again. You shall not. Okay. Take the name of the Lord. Say it after me. Take the name of the Lord. Okay, so let's put the two together. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. Let's say it again. Your God in vain. Okay, so put the three together and then we'll start from the top. Are you ready? Let's go. Exodus chapter 20, verse 7. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. Very good. Okay, so let's look at our second memory verse. Our second memory verse is from Exodus chapter 20, verse 16. Exodus chapter 20, verse 16, and it says, "You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor." This one we can break into two parts so that it's easy for us. So the first part, you shall not bear. Say it after me. You shall not bear. One last time. You shall not bear. Okay. The second part. False witness against your neighbor. Let's say it again. False witness against your neighbor. Let's put it together and then we start from the top. Ready? Okay. So our second memory verse. Exodus chapter 20, verse 16. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. Exodus chapter 20, verse 16. Very good. So let's continue to learn them and then say it to our family, to our friends, to everyone that we meet. Okay. Bye-bye.
Welcome back, guys. I hope we all heard the memory verse and have memorized it. It reminded me that I must use my tongue for good things only, not to say bad things, but good things as well. Great, this has been a very lovely lesson. Now we are going to go over and review our lesson points. So for our first question, what do we mean by misusing God's name? We said that that means using God's name in a way that does not show respect, or using God's name when we are not actually talking about Him. And we saw an example earlier today. Great. And then secondly, what does it mean when we say we should not give false testimony? Good! That means we should not lie. So we are not supposed to lie. Great. That is very wonderful. Now, who remembers the two images we compared the tongue to? The first one was an animal. Who remembers? A horse.
Great. And what was in the horse's mouth, if you remember? A bit. Great. A bit. And the bit is used to control the horse and guide it where it should go. Then the next one was a big thing on the sea. A ship. Great. Or a boat. And what controls the boat? What was the name? A rudder. Yes. The small wheel. And we saw that it's used to control the whole boat. Great! You guys are sharp. Now, how is the tongue like these two images that we saw? Yes, the tongue is small but can be used to do great things. It can be used to say good things that will build people up and encourage them. Or it can be used to say bad things that tear people down and cause problems. So the tongue is also small but can do big things. And we saw that the tongue can be like fire, which can set a whole forest on fire. It can be like a small spark that sets the whole forest on fire. Great. Now, in what way do we say our tongue should be like a fruit tree? We said that the tongue, just like the fruit tree gives off just one fruit, our tongues are also supposed to give off one kind of speech. So if our tongues are supposed to be used for good things like God says, we should not also be using our tongues to say bad things. Great! You guys are so sharp. Wow! Great! So now, let's look at the following scenario. I want you to tell me how we should react, what we should say. If you are at home, and maybe you are having fun in your room playing and you're making noise, having fun with your friends, and mommy comes to the room and shouts, "Keep quiet, you guys are making too much noise." Are we supposed to get angry and shout back at mommy or say something that's not nice to mommy? No. So what should we do instead? I want you to tell me, what should we do? Well, yeah, one option is that maybe we could just tell mommy that, "Sorry mommy, I didn't know we were making so much noise. Tone down our voices." Isn't that very nice? Good. You guys are good. Let's clap for ourselves. We are now going to have our craft, and Auntie Emily and her family will be taking us through that. Let's all follow through, get the materials if we have them at home, and work on the craft. See you soon.
Hello everyone. For today's craft, we're going to be making this. So this is a sheet with two faces. One is a smiley face and the other is an angry face. The smiley face is telling us things that God wants us to say, and the angry face is telling us things God doesn't want us to say. For crafts, you'll need a scissors, glue, a pencil, a pen or a glitter pen, and a marker. If you don't have a marker, you can use a crayon or a color pencil. You'll also need two sheets of colored paper, one for the faces and then one for the tongue. When you get, you pick one sheet of your colored paper and you fold it into two to get two halves. So I've already drawn my smiley faces. This is my I've already drawn my faces. This is my smiley face and this is my angry face. So now I'm going to trace the faces out with a marker. And as I said, if you don't have one, you can use a crayon or a color pencil. Okay. So, I've traced it out with a marker and it looks like this. Now I'm going to put this aside and get the second sheet. You draw a tongue on it. I've already drawn that, I don't know if you can see, but I've drawn a tongue here. And then you fold your paper into two for two tongues and you cut it out. So these are my two tongues. And I get, put this aside, and I get my sheet with a smiley and an angry face. And I put glue just at the tip of this here so that I can stick it onto the mouths of the faces. I'm going to put glue on it. Stick the first one in the first face. The second one.
Awesome! Guys, it has been so much fun with you today. Even as we close, I hope that as we go through the week, we'll remember that we are supposed to use our tongues for and not to say bad things as well. So let's remember and practice even as we go through the week. Till we meet again next time, guys. Have a good week. Bye.
We appreciate you joining our service today. Please subscribe to our channel by clicking on the logo and don't forget to like and share. See you next week. God bless you.